This is the story of a local woman whose simple idea to boost military morale turned into an extraordinary endeavor, one that's about to end, but not without leaving a lasting impression here and around the world.
It might just seem like a clutter to everyone watching. This is 8 years of my life, and all started with just the idea that we wanted to make sure Pierce County troops knew that they were supported.
In that 8 years, Liz Jackson's effort to honor local servicemen and women exploded into a worldwide campaign that sent 40,000 hometown t-shirts from police and fire departments to those fighting overseas. This crowded room in her house is a testament to her work.
I like this.
Oh, absolutely. Says it all.
It's a telling slogan that shows the close relationship between heroes here and over there. Thus the name of her project, Hero to Hero.
The ultimate show of support is to give the shirt off your back. Every one of those troops out there is from a hometown somewhere. Every one of these shirts has a hometown on it. Let's kind of get it together.
It was a shirt, a jersey actually, that sparked the idea.
This is what started all of it here. 55. People ask why 55. Jake's high school football jersey, they retired number 55, and it was that moment that they made that announcement that I couldn't take it. I didn't want to see another name on another wall, and we started the national tours, 55 cities across the country.
55 cities that donated to the cause. It would be the first of many nationwide tours to collect shirts from police and fire departments and to do something else, honor local firefighters and police who put their lives on the line back home, from the littlest towns to the biggest cities, and the 9/11 attack.
Robert Fody was one of the firefighters who went into the towers, and they've never found his remains, and his mother was honored. Karen actually presented this with one of our Marine members.
Karen is Karen Lemming. She's with the Tacoma Fire Department and one of the many volunteers who didn't want the troops forgotten.
That's what it's about, letting them know that we have not forgotten them. We can't do very much sometimes, but just letting them know that we are thinking about them and they do matter to us, I think that's what's important.
Karen comes from a military family. Her son was in the Gulf War. She knows the power of Hero to Hero and how hard it is to have a loved one deployed.
I could hear the national anthem and I would start crying. It's just something that, it's hard to explain, unless you've been there, so.
Remember the hero wall in Liz Jackson's house? There's another one nearby in DuPont that's close to her heart. The new memorial to DuPont's hometown heroes lost in the War on Terror.
They put up that memorial on the War on Terrorism, and it was done with such class, such thought, such real emotion behind it that it captured exactly what it's about. They've lost enough of their own for such a small community to lose the number they have. DuPont has a really special place in my heart. I think across the country, it sums up, there's something about that little town that sums up the whole feel of what patriotism truly is, from the mayor and the city council and the citizens that come out.
For her part, the journey is coming to an end. As Mideast wars drift to the background for many Americans, donations are falling off, and Liz Jackson's Hero to Hero is standing at ease, for now. But she has no regrets.
I can look in the mirror and say, I did what I could, and because of this program, a lot of people who would have otherwise simply put a magnet on their car and said they were supporting the troops came out, stood with us, across the country, across North America, and around the world, and did something too. We all took that one step that took us thousands of miles, twice around the equator. That's why.
And in the future, if any serviceman or woman asks, Liz promises to put a shirt on their back from their city back home.